Her smile has Dream Girl written all over it.
You have to keep smiling and be like all so lovely. I try to make up for it with my smile. Hopefully that works. Thanks to Mommy Ujala and Daddy Prakash.
But behind that dreamy smile is a star who's unapologetically ambitious.
I believe that this is just the beginning. Super success, lots of love. I think that's what keeps an actor going.
Impossibly reserved.
I'm a very shy person. I take time to open up.
Hardworking and always raring to go.
I mean, it's hot outside, but then you have to be cool.
Juggling three films at one go, she is the busiest actor in town.
I'm going inside while you stay outside.
I pity you, man. What a boy.
I hope you guys had a good time waiting outside.
Chasing her for over a month, we tap into the world of Deepika Padukone.
Here is someone who's got all that it takes classically to be a big movie star, and then has the acting prowess that she allows people to mold her the way according to the script and as a director.
That woman works like a machine. She's always on. Like, she doesn't get tired. So at times when I'm tired, I kind of wonder, I'm like, if she's not tired, why the hell am I?
She's someone who has absolutely no airs. I remember I had a baby during the making of Love Aajkal, and she would come to my house for fittings while I was looking after my baby.
I think she's quite funny, and a lot of her goofiness and funniness she doesn't necessarily show. That's what's got her that dimple. She's just smiling all the time, so, and laughing all the time.
She has this persona of a very glamorous girl, but she's very earthy, you know, she is like one of us.
Photographer's delight. It's no surprise that our first day of shoot with Deepika Padukone is on the sets of a photo shoot.
What are you up to today? Tell us a little bit about what we can expect.
So today we're shooting for People Magazine's most beautiful issue, and clearly they've lost the plot. Happy to be on a magazine cover. I love doing photo shoots. It's very, very refreshing and different from being on a film set. Mm-hmm. And I have a great team that I always work with. I have Anil Chinnappa, who's doing hair and makeup. I have Shalina, who's doing my clothes. And we have Tarun Bishwa, who's one of my most favorite photographers. So it's fun. We listen to music and we just go with the flow. I think I survive on music, you know, whenever I've done interviews, people have always asked me what is my hobby, and music has always been something that I've really, really enjoyed, and different kinds of music. So music is what I survive on, and depending on the theme and the mood, we play that kind of music, and we do the photo shoot.
Hers is a face that has lit up several magazine covers. A face that exudes a rare blend of sensuality and elegance.
I've grown up watching magazines with, you know, with other actresses, on the cover. And today I get the opportunity to do that. So I think it feels great, but at the same time I believe that it's a result of the work that I do, the films that I do, the characters that I play, and I guess all the love and appreciation that I get is a result of that. So I think I just need to, you know, keep my head down and keep focused on my work, And all of this is great, it's fun.
Her first love was always more towards modeling. You know, she would go for ballet classes, and then she would walk the ramp even as child artist. So we could see that her interest was more towards that. So academically she was all right. We were called once in a while to keep us informed of what was happening in school.
I enjoy, dressing up, getting ready, but I think something that I've always maintained is that it can't take away from the person that I am or my personality, which often happens when you're doing like fashion shoots or shooting for fashion magazines. It becomes so much about the fashion, which is great. But I think you can't lose out on the fact that, you have your own identity and you kind of need to say it more simply, I think, to be able to do looks that you are comfortable in or that suit you, suit your personality, I think that's very important. I hope you guys had a good time waiting outside.
We're going to follow you to the other event.
And so I'll see you there. Are you ready? Yeah? Chalo.
Four changes, 8 hours later, it's finally a wrap. But Padukone's day is nowhere close to ending. As we wait in her vanity van, Deepika changes into an evening gown as she heads out to an award ceremony.
Thank you. Do you want to talk to us a little about your vanity van? It's very girly, very, very fun. Is that you?
I think collectively, I probably spend more time in my vanity van or on a film set more than I'm even spending at home. In the last year or so, that's how it's been, and that's how it's going to be for at least the next 6 months. So it's always nice to be in a space that you're familiar with, something that you've done up with your personal touch, so that you feel comfortable.
So is that it? What, can you talk for us a little about it?
No. So I'm not taking you through my van, it's a very personal space. See you!
And she's gotten herself an award, and quite a quirky one at that.
No? I think it's very sweet. Actually, I haven't even had time to sort of look at it.
What does it say, Deepika?
Grazia Young Fashion Awards 2013, but I can tell you that it's for Cover Girl of the Year.
Where do you go from here? Are you wrapping up your day?
Done for the day. I'm going to go home, have some dinner, and go to sleep. I have an early morning flight to Bangalore tomorrow.
Which is home, so excited. Do you need these breaks once?
It's a sudden break that I got. 2 days because some shoots got cancelled. So I've managed to get 2 days off, and I promised my mom I'll come home and spend some time with them because I haven't spent any time with them. I've actually been missing them a little bit, so I'll go home and spend some time with them.
Bye.
See you.
Bye.
Thank you so much.
See you. Despite being the daughter of one of India's most successful sportsmen, it was the world of glamour that attracted the picker.
Bye.
Even though I would have personally, liked her to be a badminton player, but I knew that, she had limitations as a badminton player. She was exceptionally good, and, she would stand out whenever she did, any shows or, in modeling or, TV ads or print ads. She had a natural flair for that.
Deepika, let me just start off with what your dad said about you. Your dad said was that, from a very young age, she was kind of always attracted to glamour and the spotlight. I want to know, do you have any memories of, in your childhood thinking that, oh, badi hoke ek din heroine banungi, or those kind of thoughts?
Well, a little bit. One of my best friends in school, Kavya Anand, her mother, Anila, was and is still one of the leading model coordinators in Bangalore.
She used to tell my mother apparently, ki, you know, why don't you get her into modeling and she should start modeling and things like that. And these conversations used to happen in front of me. And my mom, I remember, would always say things like, you know, listen, she's too young, don't put these thoughts in her head right now, we'll think about it later, but let her at least finish her education. That's how it started actually. And, you know, thanks to Anila, I managed to do a couple of print campaigns when I was young. And that was sort of my first experience in front of the camera. Offers were pouring in and I was really, really tempted. And Anila also suggested, she said, you know, this is the age to do these things. You know, she can always study later, but don't wait. You know, let her start. And so that's how it all began.
Another day, another event. This time, Deepika is fulfilling a brand commitment.
Hello. I pity you, man. What a boring life. I'm sure you follow me. You allow me to take your hands.
Bangalore was lovely. Spent a day with my parents. Made them happy. Yeah, I mean, I go only for a day, 2 days. So it's nice. I mean, I don't go out much. I'm mostly at home.
What are we up to today?
So we're here for a Tissot event, a brand that I've been with for 6 years now. I think they spotted talent way before anyone else, and it's one of my first big endorsements that I signed internationally. And in fact, this is Maria from Tissot. Say hello.
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 And we're tracking the life of a star.
Face of close to 15 brands, today Deepika's at the unveiling of a premium watch brand.
I think she brings tremendous success and she brings tremendous likability. The fact that she is an Indian girl from a normal rooted Indian family who's made this on her own, it's not like she had some godfather, it's not like she's a star kid, and she's gone out there and just by dint of hard work become the biggest star in the country. Obviously, it's a story that I think many, many people can relate to here. Honestly, as a brand ambassador, she's the biggest female brand ambassador in the country today, right? She does more brands, most of them are A-list brands. And I think that our criteria is, okay, if there's a brand that we think she's happy to be a part of, where the money is right, that's all that there is to it.
Post the launch, Deepika spends the rest of the day giving interviews. Meanwhile, we move to her next stop, the famous BR Studios in Juhu, where Deepika is expected to arrive for a dubbing session.
Say hi.
Hi, how are you?
Say hi to this camera.
Hello,
and
how
say
are you?
Hi to this
how
camera.
Are you?
Please ask everybody how they're doing.
How are you doing? Hope you're having a good day.
Have some nice conversation with people.
I don't know what to say. I don't know.
Are you? Sharan is... kya? Sharan is a very, very important part of Ye Jawani Hai Deewani, and I don't think this film would have been possible without him. He's actually the one thing that's been like consistent and constant through the film.
He's blushing.
And he's always blushing.
The money has reached
and he's kind of held everybody together, yeah, at times when I think everyone, like people were stressful and things were kind of falling apart. He's kind of held everything together. So I'm here now to dub for Ye Jawani Hai Deewani. Although it was primarily sync sound, but sometimes if you have like a generator running or if you have birds chirping or like if you're shooting in a sort of crowded place, then the voices are not clear and then you have to redub some of the scenes.
From Veronica to Scholar Nena.
Interesting, no? I think people were really surprised when they saw the first when they saw the trailer for the first time, to see me play like this spectacled, simple girl, you know, but it's nice. I think that's always the fun part of being an actor, you know, to do different kinds of films and to play different roles and then to dress up differently.
You wanna go inside?
Yeah.
Or are you?
Well, I'm going inside while you stay outside. See you.
Thank
Bye.
You.
Bye.
2 hours later.
That was fun. I got done with a couple of scenes and well, we still have a long way to go, but at least I've started.
I think a director's main worry is always when the actors haven't started. And I think once you start, then you sort of you kind of get into the flow and then you finish fast.
Long day, wrapped up.
Long day done. I have to go home and pack because I'm off to Jaipur tomorrow to shoot for Ram Leela.
You are always packing, aren't you?
Yeah. See you.
Bye. Thank you so much.
Bye. It's a hot summer's day, and the heat seems to be getting to everybody, even Deepika Padukone.
Deepika, अब तक का सबसे best compliment क्या मिला है तुमको? तुमको release होने से पहले काफी सराहा जा रहा है, काफी पसंद करा जा रहा है, चाहे उनके गाने हो चाहे promo, वो तो best compliment है.
I think it's too soon to tell. I think it's nice to know that people are enjoying the songs, they love the music. People have taken to the trailer really well. And it would be nice if you can not talk while I'm giving my answer. Thank you very much. If you want to win this t-shirt, specially autographed by me, then follow the instructions. Bye, see you.
But flaunting that famous smile.
Where do we go next?
Deepika shooting back-to-back interviews.
Well, first day, second day of promotions for Ye Jawani Hai Deewani, and I have to run. Miss Qureshi. No, you may not hold on. Nilufar Qureshi. Nilufar, say hi. Come on. And wake up, Sid. Lots of interviews. Waiting for my co-star to arrive. Finishing off all the solo interviews before he comes.
It's hot. And how are you dealing?
I know it's very hot, but then you have to keep smiling and be like all so lovely. I mean, it's hot outside, but then you have to be cool. Right. I have to go now. See you.
On her never-ending trail of promotional events, today we are visiting the office of an industry trade magazine.
And basically, we take your take on the various sections, not of the magazine per se, but like reviews, do they matter, getting the right release date, collection.
Take on this thing.
Sure. Okay.
How did it go, Deepika?
Good.
Yeah,
good fun. Yeah.
I spoke quite a lot.
I hope we didn't bore you.
So what were you talking about? Numbers? In the box office games?
In fact, we spoke about everything but numbers. Because I said that's something I'm very uncomfortable with.
As Deepika shoots some more interviews, we use the opportunity to chat up her staff. Meet Shanu, the man responsible for ferrying Deepika back and forth from all her various commitments.
ऐसे तो नाम मेरा विष्णु सारू मंगर है लेकिन सब सानू कहते हैं मुझे तो दीदी भी मुझे सानू करते हैं लेकिन मेरा आईडी प्रूफ जो है विष्णु सारू मंगर से
दीदी कौन है
दीपिका पाडुकोन
दीदी क्यों बुलाते हो
ऐसे मतलब अच्छा लगता है दीदी मुझे रिलेशन जैसा होता है अपना जैसा कि मैं काम करता हूँ ऐसा लगता नहीं कि मैं दूसरे के पास काम करता हूँ
कब से काम कर रहा हूँ
मैं 2007 जून 18 जून को ज्वाइन किया हूँ
मतलब तभी क्या चल रहा था उन्होंने वो किया था
हाँ चालू था मतलब शूटिंग चालू था मैं रनिंग में मैं ज्वाइन किया दीदी का तो जैसा दीदी का अभी बिजी रहते हैं दीदी उस हिसाब से मुझे भी बिजी रहना पड़ता है सुबह स्टार्ट करता हूँ और लास्ट एंडिंग में घर जाता हूँ। ऐसे लगता नहीं कि मैं 6 साल गुजर दिया हूँ, ऐसे लगता है अभी ड्यूटी कर रहा हूँ मैं ज्वाइन। ऐसा
उनके बारे में बताइए, वो कैसी है?
मेरे लिए तो बहुत अच्छा है क्योंकि अभी मैं मेहनत काम करता हूँ, मैं बहुत खुश हूँ और मेरे परिवार के लिए मैं जो मतलब सोचा हूँ वो सब हो रहा है मेरे लिए। तो दीदी भी मेरे बारे में बहुत सोचता है।
Fashionista was always picture perfect. Mehra and Gohar are the ladies responsible for Deepika's glam look.
She is very comfortable in her own skin. She's very confident in what she's doing. She's very sure of what she is as a person. And I think that comes out, you know, because when you're real and true to yourself, you don't have to live up to pretenses. You're not insecure about that. And that shows.
But while I'm modeling also, we was used to always feel she's going to become a superstar one day.
As a person to work with, she's lovely. She's very professional. She knows what works, what doesn't work. She's always open to suggestions. And touch wood, we have a very good working relationship.
She was not the only model who's, sorry to say, but sometimes they are not so intelligent. But she was very intelligent. That time only you can make out ki one day she's going to be a superstar, for sure.
One thing someone on your entourage told me, I'm not going to tell you who, was that from when she started working with you on the Kingfisher calendar, she always knew that you were going to be a star.
I know who it is.
It's kind of obvious.
I know who it is. Did I know? There's certain things that you want, you know, in your life, and you start working towards it and then you start achieving it. I'm not talking about stardom, but I'm just generally saying everyone has a plan, everybody, and your plans don't have to be major plans. Your plans could be something as, you know, something as simple as, you know what, next year I want to spend a month with my family or whatever, you know, just little things that you want for yourself, for your life, but you're not going about your everyday work keeping that in mind, you know. And you work towards it. In a subconscious manner, you work towards it.
We've been shooting in the night, promoting in the day, at times going to cover launches. So there have been days when we've slept for like 3 hours and 2 hours.
What's the one thing that kind of attracts you to kind of keep working with her?
Well, you know, with Deepika, the best part is that she's also a lot of fun to work with. She's young, so she has her crazy times where we'd indulge and we'd be like, you know, oh, let's eat some chocolate today. And she's not one of those starry people who would be like, you know, oh, okay, you're my manager, you sit outside and this should be done, you know. She's a lot of fun otherwise to hang with, whether we've been on outdoors, so we've played games and we've partied, so it's a lot of fun, there's a lot of incentive. And at times when I take a break or if I've taken a day off, I then miss her, you know, and I want to go back.
What's the one thing, like, you know, that you kind of get irritated with sometimes?
Well, I want her to now take a break for a bit so that we all can take a break, so we all can sleep. Because as you see, we all look really sleep deprived.
It seems like they've become first family. I see them more than I see my parents. I see them every day. You know, they're sort of the people who've kept me going. You know, whether it's Mehra, whether it's Gohar, whether it's my team at Kwan, whether it's Karthik, whether it's Sanu, whether it's my maid Bharti and Sunita and Lily at home. It's just that, you know, we are the face of everything that we do, whether it's a film, whether it's an endorsement. But I think we often forget that team that's working tirelessly for you. And in fact, just yesterday I was mentioning to Mehra because she sent me a lovely message about my performance in Ye Jawani Hai Deewani. And I said to her that they all have been my strength in what I would say the toughest phase in my career. And, you know, not a single day of cribbing or saying that they're tired or that they can't keep up.
It's now close to 9 p.m. A tired Deepika walks out of the studios with some bad news.
You're almost done for the day?
Yes, I'm almost done for the day. Shoot today has been cancelled because I've hurt my back. So no shoot today. I'm going to head home and I'm going to rest my back.
What happened to your back?
Stop being so inconsiderate, okay?
What
happened to your back?
What happened to your back, Deepika?
Can you not be a journalist for like 2 minutes? So what happened to my back is we were meant to start shooting a song from today for Ramlila. So I was rehearsing for that, and I know I have sprained my back muscle.
So I've been asked to rest for a couple of days till it heals. So I'm going to go back to shoot tomorrow, but we're not going to do anything strenuous. And then in about 3-4 days, I can get back to shoot.
Okay. Take care.
See you. Bye. Bye.
It's been more than a week since we last saw the star, this time catching up with Deepika in Bengaluru. And as usual, she's in a tearing hurry.
Move it. I have no time to talk to you right now. I'm really, really late. Come fast.
Let's finally get you to introduce us to
my little baby sister.
And since it's her hometown, Deepika has her younger sister, Anisha, for company.
Amin bhai, aap.
Is there going to be a sister moment happening?
That's Mehra.
Yeah,
and Gohar, you know. Yeah. And that's Sneha.
Hi, we've also from Mounts. We're all the Carmelites. Why are you here? You're a little unwell also, right?
Yes. Something I haven't told my parents, so please don't tell them. Yeah, I'm here to promote Ye Jawani Hai Deewani. I'm coming from a shoot for Chennai Express. I started shooting yesterday afternoon. I packed up at 8 a.m. this morning.
Okay.
So, see you in a bit.
Side, move. Please move.
Hi. Okay.
This gives us a chance to speak to perhaps the most important person in Deepika's entourage. The man responsible for her security, Karthik.
तो outdoor जाते तो और मतलब difficult हो जाता है ना अभी तो तुम mall में जाने वाले हो recce कुछ करने का time तो नहीं
है recce तो नहीं but others जो मेरे दूसरे हैं help करते हैं जो security के
कितने लोग होते हैं usually events में जब जाते हो
दिल्ली ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा 10 से 12 लोग होते ही हाँ उन्होंने ऑलरेडी रखी किया
काफी क्राउड है वैसे वहाँ रेडी हो
यस
है बैक आ रहे हैं बैक इधर है मैं भी एक मिनट
में आ रहा हूँ 10 मिनट्स लेटर पार्टिकल्स रेडी टू रोल
आई सजेस्टेड माउंट्स बट इट वाज शट दैट
वाज क्विक यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू माउंट्स
दे आर शट
इट्स हॉलिडे
वी हैड टू डू अ कॉलेज विजिट एंड आई सजेस्टेड गोइंग बैक टू स्कूल एंड कॉलेज
राइट
But they're shut for, I think, holidays.
Okay.
So we're going to Presidency College because they have some last exam today.
And it's going to be some treat.
And yeah, I'm their entertainment after their last exam.
Does it happen often that you come to Bangalore and don't get to go home?
No. When I do come, I make it a point to go home, even if it's for a couple of hours. I wouldn't be able to sleep peacefully if I came to Bangalore and didn't go home. Everybody meet Shalina. Say hi.
Thank you. We supposed to do that. She doesn't speak to us. Express.
How we've done makeup in the plane. So we did ice in the plane and then we said, okay, we'll have 10 minutes in the room because I wanted to ice my face and all get fresh. So we said we'll do base in the room and while she's doing base, she can finish off hair. Then, so we didn't do, we did only ice. Then we sat in the car and that's it, kept saying, we're really late. So finally at one signal, Karishma was sitting with me, she got down, Mehra came in, did the base. She finished everything, Mehra got down, Gaur came in, did hair.
Deepika's visiting a local mall where she first meets waiting journalists.
There's a question coming from Nakai. Oh, here, okay.
She's there.
Here.
The spoofy version of that is Naina says, Bunny, agar main tumhare saath 2 minute aur rahi, and Bunny says, to kya Naina? And Naina says, meri Maggie jal jayegi, Bunny.
then the fan mania begins. Stop is a local college.
Around you, and we've just been happily oblivious to it. Is that how you try to keep your world?
We're in Bangalore today, and you see the kind of love, like I was mentioning to you earlier, people here feel like I'm theirs, you know, I was brought up here. And I have such a strong Bangalore connect that they love it when I come back. I was very naughty. My mother would always say that the first 5 years before Anisha was born, you could never find Deepika on ground level. I was always apparently like jumping up on tables, jumping off sofas, climbing up on beds, just like all over the place.
And how did that Deepika transform into one of the most poised and elegant actresses that we have?
I think that's thanks to the birth of Anisha Padukone that I've become like this, because that's what my mom says. My mom says that the minute Anisha was born, I've become like really a lot more quiet, and I started become this, you know, this motherly, protective sister.
Anisha, how difficult or fun is it to be the sister of a superstar, considering you also have a really flourishing career of your own?
I don't think it's any different from being a regular sister to anyone else. I knew her even before she was a star. And
for instance, if you wanted to go grab a coffee with her, could you?
Yeah, of course. I mean, those things change, but that's part of being in the industry or being...
But you wouldn't want it any other way, would you?
No, I'm very happy where she's reached, and I know she'll achieve a lot more. And if that's the price that you have to pay, not being able to go out in public, then so be it.
She's as poised as you.
Absolutely. I think this is our father's training. I think both we've learned. Yeah, we've both learned from him to be. So when the media guys complain about being politically correct, you know where it's coming from.
No prizes for guessing. Who is your favorite actress?
You tell me.
Deepika, before
can't
you...
Can't be me.
No.
Oh, who'd say?
They were made to wait, but honestly, I mean, I have nothing to do with that. But I feel bad because, you know, you guys do such an amazing job. But I think it went off well. Otherwise, I tried to make up for it with my smile. Hopefully that works.
See you.
It's our last day of tracking Deepika, and our shoot has completed a full circle. Ending where we started, today Deepika is launching the People magazine's Most Beautiful cover. A shoot we captured on our first meeting with the actor.
Absolutely. I mean, I go to bed every night thinking that I'm the most beautiful woman in the world. Come on, really.
Come on.
Listen.
So what, how do you feel with something like this? Do you start?
I mean, of course it feels nice. But like I said earlier on, I mean, I have really nothing to do with it. I think it's thanks to mommy Ujala and daddy Prakash for all the features and for the eyes and for the dimples. I have nothing to do with this. Yeah.
So actually the first time that I worked with Deepika was when she was a runway model. I remember noticing her because she was this athletic Amazonian bronzed beauty. And she stood out because she had this very quiet way about her. But when she walked on the ramp, I mean, there was no messing with her. I think she has a natural beauty. and she's totally unaffected by her success.
Born to doting parents, Ujala and badminton champ Prakash Padukone, despite the normal upbringing, growing up, Deepika constantly found herself under the spotlight.
At home, we had a very, very normal upbringing, like anybody else. But I think in school, I was always Prakash Padukone's daughter. So everything is magnified. If you do well, it's magnified. If you don't do well, or if you bully someone, if you trouble someone, everything is like, oh, you're Prakash Padukone's daughter. You know, she got caught, or she did this, or she did that, or whatever it is, you know. But yes, definitely it was a lot easier earlier on to sort of move around, to travel, to go out. I miss doing the normal things, but I'm not complaining because I also feel like I'm living the life that I've always wanted to. I'm doing exactly what I wanted to, and I'm not complaining.
Today she's at the top spot. With back-to-back record-breaking hits, hardly anyone can compete with her box office standing.
So it's definitely a very, very important time in my career, and a very interesting time, I think, because like I said, I've sort of challenged myself and done some films that, you know, Ram Leela and Chennai Express and Ye Jawani, these three films are so different from each other, the makers are so different from each other. So I'm experimenting, I'm doing different things, and I hope that it all pays off eventually.
The greatest quality Deepika has is that she is quite moldable in the hands of the script and the filmmaker. And that's something I realized when we did Om Shanti Om. She was a rank newcomer. Of course, a supermodel. I saw her pictures. I remember the first time I was shown her picture, she was lying on a rock in a bikini. And she was supposed to play Shanti Priya, the 70s look. And I told Farah, I can't tell. I was in Malaysia shooting Dawn. And I said, this picture is a little contrary to what we're thinking. And then she came home, dressed as Shanti Priya. And I just come back to show the look. And it was completely a different person. So I think she has that quality that you can mold her because she does not come with any preset notions of what is the performance that she's going to do. And, you know, that's a great quality in acting. It's the humility of acting, which she has, and still a lot of pride in what she does. Initially, she did ask me a couple of films, and I think a couple of times I did give her wrong advice too, but she's never held it against me. And as we've grown to know each other, you know, she's like a part of family, and I feel really thrilled whenever I get an opportunity to work with her.
As an actor, I think she is one actor with whom I have worked now. So I can say this, you can experiment with her. You know, I have told her that I'll write a script for her of one character. You know, the way she speaks, she has this thing of saying tomato sauce. So I said, I'll write the whole film, and she keeps on enacting that, okay, I'll say this line this way, this line this way. So another wacko film I'll do with her. And she's fabulous. She's fabulous. The actor inside Deepika Padukone, you know, and the kind of dedication she has towards work. And I think you can make out she wants to be, I don't know, I don't believe in this number game, 1, 2, 3, but she wants to be the biggest actor and star of a country, and I think that will happen, and that's going to happen very soon. Yes, I respect her for her focus, for her dedication towards a particular character or towards her work. I really like that.
Deepika on screen is a lot more controlled. Deepika off screen is a lot easier and a lot lighter. And I feel now, over time, now it's been 3 years now, and I feel like she's opened up a lot. She's allowed that other Deepika to come into her on-screen persona, and whether it was in Cocktail, whether it was in even Kartik, calling Kartik, I thought was, you know, a slight step forward. And so I feel like she's kind of gradually brought more of herself, which is actually very relaxed. She likes to have things in order. She is somebody who's OCD, but she's a really relaxed person in terms of friendships, equations, people, and very loving and giving. So I think a lot of that joy and that liveliness that she has, she's managed to bring on screen.
But at her unswerving high, would Deepika ever consider giving it all up?
Absolutely. I'm sure there will come a day where I feel like, you know, I've been here enough, and you know, you want to sort of move on to other things. It's also a woman thing. It's also an Indian woman thing, I feel. It's every girl's dream, you know, to get married and to have that perfect, beautiful wedding. and to be happily married and to have children scuttling about. That's every woman's dream. But I think right now I'm just happy focusing on my work, because this itself for me is a new phase in my career, I feel. And I'm enjoying that.
I personally feel that your achievements in a particular field, you know, whether it's in sports or in acting or in as an, you know, in any field, should not change you as a person. So that's been my philosophy throughout, and that's what we've tried to inculcate to our children. So I'm very confident that, you know, once her, you know, acting career is over, she'll, you know, I don't think she'll find it very difficult to, you know, to be a normal human being.
Achiever, go-getter, current numero uno. But she's not done yet.
What all is left to be achieved?
There's a lot. There's a lot. I believe that this is just the beginning. Super success, lots of love. I think that's what keeps an actor going. You know, the love that you get from the audience. That's what really keeps you going, and they love you in spite of your hits and your misses. They still love you and they still appreciate everything that you do, and that's really that driving force. That's what really keeps you going. So hopefully a lot more of that.
Clearly the sky is the limit for this star.